So my brothers and sisters, I need your help. The church needs your help. Because the church has a mission to bring the good news to the entire world. A mission we received from God Almighty himself. When Jesus ascended into heaven, he said, "Go therefore, make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. Behold, I am with you always, to the end of the world." He said, "Go and announce, go and announce." And there are 5 billion people on this earth who do not know Jesus Christ still to this day. 5 billion people who do not know that God died and rose from the dead for them. That God so loved the world, he gave us his only Son, so those who believe in him may not perish but have eternal life. There are 5 billion people who do not know Jesus Christ. And that Jesus Christ died for these people, they don't know him. He loves them, and they don't know that love. They've been created for that love, but they don't know. And they don't know Christ almost always for one simple reason. Because Catholics that do know Jesus aren't sharing the faith, aren't living that mission to go and announce. So I need your help, right? We have this mission. Now, one of the things that, you know, used to be in this mindset of a lot of people, and maybe it still is in the mindset of some people, when we hear about evangelization, we hear about sharing the good news, is to think, well, Father, that's your job. You know, that's what you're supposed to be doing all day. You know, I go to church. That's good. That's my job. I go to church. I show up. Right? Okay, well, let's do the math. I like math. I'm a nerd. Let's do the math. Okay, there are 1.3 billion Catholics on the earth right now. 1.3 billion baptized Catholics. There are 414,000 Catholic priests. Now, 414,000 sounds like a lot, but how much is that for 1.3 billion Catholics? Well, that's one priest for every 3,000 Catholics. Over 3,000 Catholics for one priest, which is bigger than a whole town I grew up in where there was multiple churches. Okay, so now, the priest has already got 3,000 people he's got to take care of. Now if we add, say, okay, well, Father, that's that 5 billion, that's your job. Okay, well, how about 5 billion for 414,000 priests? That means I got to convert 12,000 people during my 50 year, if I'm a priest for 50 years, I got to convert 12,000 people, which if I, you know, make it in parish ministry 50 years before I croak, that's 241 converts every year. I got to go get 241 people in RCIA every year by myself, no help from anybody else. 5 people a week, I got to figure out how to evangelize. Right? 12,000 for each priest. Now, man, while taking care of the 3,000. So is that the system? Is that it? Is that how that's supposed to work? Now let's look at, what if every Catholic embraced that confirmation mission, that mission that we received in baptism and confirmation to go share the good news? Right, 5 billion people. Now we'll simplify the math. Right, 5 billion people who don't know Jesus Christ for a billion Catholics. How many non-Catholics does the Catholic have to try to convert, bring into the church? 5. So 5 versus 12,000. 5 per person or versus 12,000 per priest. Which system do you think Jesus set up? I think it was the 5. Right. Because he knew that it's not really possible to try to figure out how to evangelize 12,000 people and then take care of 15,000 people, right? But each Catholic inviting and inviting and inviting, you know, to try to win, how can, you know, can we bring 5 people into the church? You know, maybe go through RCIA with these people 5 times, you know, 60, you know, if you're trying to live in this mission, 5 people in 60 years, you know, it's going through RCA every 12 years, probably a good refresher course. Walking with somebody, hey, I'll go with you. Man, what a difference. Could have this world converted if we embrace this mission. We got enough people. We have enough people. But do we have enough willing people? And so I think there's a temptation today, a very pernicious kind of brainwashing that's been going on in our society, this pernicious temptation, lie, that says, well, you just can't talk about religion to people. You can't talk about religion and politics. It's not polite. You can't talk about these things. You know, don't push your religion onto people. Don't push your faith on people. Right? You want to push your food pictures? Go ahead. Take pictures of meals, you know, share funny cat videos. But you can't talk about salvation, heaven, getting the infinite love of Jesus Christ. Oh, no, no. Just your food. No. What's going on there? Who's that belief system from? It ain't from God. You can see who it's from. It's from the evil one. Right? And it's really rooted in this other lie of relativism, that there's no truth, that there's no purpose, that there's no answer for everyone. Like so everyone has to just do whatever. Right? There's this lie that, well, you know, you can't tell people what they should do or how they should live, because everybody just needs to do whatever makes them happy. They just need to do whatever they feel like doing. There's no big answer for everybody. Wait a second. That's a real, real evil lie from the evil one. If we dive into that, we look at that clearly, you see that that's the devil trying to get us to live like the animals. Right? What's that saying is you know, people just need to do whatever they feel like, do whatever they desire, do whatever they want, when they want. That's how animals live. Right? That's the evil one trying to get us to live like the animals instead of like children of God, to live beneath our dignity than our actual true dignity. Right? Because imagine saying this, well, I can't push my beliefs on people, that people are made for the infinite love of God. Maybe they're made for something else. What's better than the infinite love of God? If you don't think the infinite love of God is the answer for every soul on earth, then you don't think very highly of people. You're treating them beneath their dignity. You're demeaning them by saying that maybe they're made for something else other than the infinite love of God. That'd be tragic. The infinite love of God is the answer. There is literally nothing better than union with God himself, the Almighty, the Infinite. It's the answer to every human heart, because every human heart was created by God. And he's revealed this. He hasn't said, just go, good luck, figure it out. This is not an opinion. This is not some opinion. This is revelation from the creator of the universe. This is good news. That we not only know the truth, but we have access to the one who is the truth, the way, the truth, and the life. He has come to save us and to bring us his very self, his very life, his very love. It's good news. We cannot be afraid to share it. We have to embrace this mission. If we are followers of Jesus Christ, we believe that this is the answer, and we believe that Jesus is the answer, we cannot keep it to ourselves. That's selfish. We cannot just live a private faith. That's selfish. God loves these people and is trying to get to them and has asked us to be his witnesses. You are witnesses of these things. Go and announce the gospel to all creation. So how do we do this, Father? Okay. All right, we agree. Yes, Father. How do we do this? Okay, so I'm going to teach you the one key, essential, most important, essential component to evangelization. Without this, evangelization is impossible. Now, there's lots of things you could say about it, but this is kind of like the infomercial. I'm going to teach you today the one key thing about evangelization. All right, what's the most important thing? It's very simple. Invite. Invitation. There can be no evangelization without an invitation. You have to actually invite people. Hey, do you want to come to church with me? All right? Hey, you ever thought about becoming Catholic? We've got these classes. I'd go with you. I could probably use a refresher course. An invitation can change lives. How many people have I heard after, you know, being teaching RCIA year after year after year as a priest? They say, why are you here? What brought you here? How many people start their story with, well, I had this friend and they invited me. They invited me to church. They invited me to RCIA. They invited me to Bible study. How many times? How beautiful. Now, just to clarify, I'm talking about an invitation. I'm not talking about a condemnation or a chastisement. You need to get to church. You're a bad person. You need God in your life. You should go to RCIA. This is not an invitation. Right? This is an invitation. Hey, I'm going to church on Sunday. You want to come with me? Hey, you ever thought about becoming Catholic? We got these classes. I'd go with you. Just putting it out there. An invitation. It's the best way to evangelize. It's the simplest way. You know, when we start with the people that we have relationships with, friendships with, invite your friends. You love your friends. You care about your friends. You know, to keep the answer from them. Oh, I want to share. It should just flow out of our conversation. Hey, these classes are starting. I love you. I care about you. You ever thought about Catholicism? I'd go with you. Check it out. It's worth it. Now, sometimes people can bring up all sorts of excuses, right, to exempt ourselves from the mission of the church or exempt ourselves from trying to share the good news. Oh, Father, you know, they're never gonna change. Father, they're just gonna say no, they're just gonna reject. There's no point. And I got a lot of things to say to that. First thing is, maybe they will. So what? You won't die. Yeah, a lot of people rejected Jesus, but did he only speak to the people that he knew would accept him? No, he scattered the seed, right? He scattered the seed. We hear the parables. Scattered the seed. Yeah, some's going to fall on rocky paths. Some is going to fall on thorns and thistles, right? But we still scatter. We're still, even if we're getting rejected over and over and over again. Right? And we got to remember, okay, yes, it's not easy to put yourself out there to share the faith and get rejected, but it's not going to kill you. You're not going to be like, they're going to say, no, I'm okay. You're like, oh, I'm dying, I'm melting, what a world. You know, this isn't the Wizard of Oz, people. It's not going to happen. No. But if we don't evangelize, we could get to that point in this country. There are countries on the earth right now. You go out and you start inviting people, there you will get killed. There will be people who will try to kill you for sharing your faith in Jesus Christ. They'll chop your head off. They'll shoot you. But we're not in that place right now. But our country is going down that path. If we don't share the faith, if we don't live our mission, there'll come a point, not only will it be said, well, that you're being offensive, but we're going to silence you. You know, we're getting to that point that if Catholics don't evangelize, don't share the faith, it's just, it could get worse and worse. But the second point, and the really key point, is people say, oh, there's no point, they're not going to listen, they're not going to change. You don't know the power of God. Don't condemn someone to hopelessness and despair and disbelief. God can work miracles. God is working on each person. God is trying to save each person. And the power of God is infinite. He can do more than we think. He is far more capable of working in people's lives than we realize, right? This is the gospel for today, right? This is how it is with the kingdom of God. As if a man were to scatter seed on the land and would sleep and rise day and night, and through it all the seed would sprout and grow, he knows not how. Right? The word of God is powerful. If we invite, you never know what could happen. Yeah, I might have to invite 500 times. Man, that fifth, 500th, that life has changed. It's worth it. And so the Lord God Almighty can work miracles with an invitation. We don't know how God's been working on them, preparing them. And imagine if every Catholic that comes to Mass at St. Augustine's took this mission and said, okay, you know what, I'm going to start inviting people. I'm going to find a way to invite a person once a week to join me at Mass. Or invite once a week, I'm going to invite someone to RCIA. I'm going to set my goal. You know, we've got several weeks. September 1st is the start date for RCIA here at this parish. We have several months. And I was like, what if every parishioner, so there's 2,300 families registered on our books, but with COVID and everything and all the stuff that's going on, probably about 1,500 people actually showing up to Mass on a Sunday right now. We've seen some numbers go down, right? You see the space. There's plenty of space. But imagine even if the 1,500 that are coming to Mass on Sunday said, you know what, I'm going to do this. I'm going to invite. You know, and they said, I'm going to invite, you know, 20 times. I'm going to 20 people, I'm going to just invite. Would you want to come to Mass with me this Sunday? Ever thought about becoming Catholic? We've got these classes. I'd go with you. Just going to put that out there. That would be 30,000 invitations over the summer. That'd be 30,000 people that got invited to Catholicism in the city of, through our parish. Even if we failed 99 times out of 100, even if we only had a 1% response rate, there would still be 300 people coming here. There would still be 300 people possibly joining the Catholic Church from our parish. Amazing. Do you know how many non-Catholics joined our Catholic Church from our parish this year? How many adult Catholic converts to Catholicism we had from our parish this past year? Zero. Zero. Now, we can blame COVID all we want, but we can't use that excuse this year. We've got a mission. And the only way we live out that mission is through invitation. And I can't invite 30,000 people. It's not possible for me to do that. But we can. Now, I read something really that was convicting to me. The bishop is having us read books on evangelization and talking about it amongst all the priests. It's a very good project. I was reading this book and it really stung me. I was like, oh, burn, where's the aloe vera? You know, and he said, if your Catholic parish were to disappear from your town overnight, would any non-Catholic even notice? I was like, oh. Well, they'd notice our food pantry being gone. But I'm not sure. Like, would there be a, like, well, those Catholics aren't inviting me to church anymore. Like, you know, and imagine if we lived that mission. Yeah, maybe a person's going to get multiple invitations. Maybe they're going to have, like, oh, yeah, all these people. You know, I would love to get complaints. Like, Father, you got to call your Catholics off. Like, I've gotten 30 invitations this week. I'm annoyed. Like, I would love to get that phone call. I'd love to get 100 of those phone calls. You know, how many of those phone calls I've gotten in 15 years of being a priest? Zero. Right? Because again, this temptation, this lie of, oh, you can't talk about that, you gotta just keep it private. This is good news. This is the answer. So now, very practically. So I created these flyers, and I have 800 of them printed out, or over 800 of them printed out, of just a simple message. Have you ever considered becoming Catholic? A little message about life is filled with questions, there are answers, Jesus is the ultimate answer, Jesus has given us a kingdom, a church, and you are invited, and an invitation to RCIA. And I want to encourage you, challenge you, beg you, to take one of these at the end of Mass, take two, take three, take five, take 20, I don't care, I'll print out 30,000, that'd be great. And invite someone to come with you to Mass. Say, hey, you want to come to Mass with me this weekend? I'm going. Love to have you. You know, invite someone to RCA. Have you ever considered becoming Catholic? You've got these classes. I'm just putting that out there. I'd go with you if you're interested. Oh, an invitation could change someone's life. Now, all right, now, fair warning. This is, you know, get your aloe vera out. You know, so I don't mean this as a guilt trip, but to really try to light a fire. Because I've done this before. I've announced this, I've printed these out, you know, at other parishes I've been at. And what happens is that after Masses, just see people just walk right past. Nope, I'm not taking one of those flyers, I'm not doing it. You know, I gotta call that out. What is that? I got a church that's good enough. You should be happy I show up at all. What is that? Is that the love of Jesus Christ? Is that saying, I want to know, love, and serve Jesus Christ? Or is that selfishness? I go for me. I go to make myself feel better. But not going to do anything. No, I got to, you know, again, the goal is not to give you a guilt trip and make you feel bad, but someone's tempted with that. I got to call that out. Is that being a disciple of Jesus Christ? Can you say you're a disciple of Jesus Christ if you don't want to share the faith? Can you say that this is the answer? No, it's got to go together. Otherwise, what is that? It's just living for ourselves. It's just using Catholicism for ourselves. And can't ask me to do anything. No, this is a way of life. This is the discipleship. This is being a follower of Jesus Christ, saying, I want to love and serve him. I want to do what he asks because I trust him, because he's good, because he's been good to me, and I know he can be good to others. So, you know, it may sting a little bit, but okay, well, here's the other one. So again, Father, I'm not saying this to make us feel bad. I don't get up and preach to make people feel bad, but I do preach sometimes to light a fire. All right, get us off our couch. Be like, the world's falling apart here, people. We got to do something. We can't just sit and watch TV. And, you know, can't just go to church. We got to go out and evangelize. So Pope Paul VI, he had this intense line also. This could be a little stinging. Pope Paul VI, he said this: all the problems of the world can be traced to one source. You ready for this? Traced to one source: lukewarm Catholics. That one's tough. Well, because we have a mission, right? Jesus is the answer. But if people don't know, they've never heard about Jesus Christ, they've never been invited. Have all of your friends been invited to Mass with you? Why not? Have all of your friends been invited to RCIA? Why not? I don't know them. You know them. I'm not. God didn't put me in their life. He put you in their life. You have access to them. They're your friends. They're your neighbors, the people you live next to, right? People at work, right? To invite. You don't know what lives can change, right? Can't. We're good at excuses, right? Well, Father, I just got to focus on my kids. I understand wanting your kids to come back to church if they're not at church. But we can't use as an excuse to say, I'm only going to focus on my kids. What about all the other people God loves and cares about? And there's 24 hours in a day. You can do both. Invitations do not take 50 hours. Right? Invitations are simple and easy. Well, come to Mass with me this Sunday. So we can't use that excuse of, I just got to focus on my kids. God has other people he wants in his family, and he's asking us, will you go and be the heart of Christ, be the hands and feet of Christ? Will you go and bring this good news to these people that Christ died for? Christ died for these 5 billion people, just like he died for all 7 billion. Christ passionately loves these people and wants them to know him, wants them to know his salvation, wants them to know his mercy, his kingdom, his grace, his truth, all these gifts that he so desperately wants to give. But what does he ask of his children, of his family? Will you go out and will you invite? Will you bring this good news? What could be better than that? It's far better than, oh, I got to get my team to the Super Bowl. Like, by moving this ball over here. Like, or I help people get to heaven. Got to see how that movie's going to play out. Got to binge watch that. Got to get people to heaven. Help them know this love of God that can satisfy the soul. This is my hope. We're going to be handing these out at the end of Mass. Don't walk out without getting one. I guess if you do, then you're going to deal with the guilt, because it's on you at that point. But what if? And yeah, might have people say no. But what if they said yes? What if? What type of lives could be changed? The power of God can change lives. The Word of God, the anointing of God. Man, what if? So let's pray for courage, my brothers and sisters. This world needs Jesus Christ, and Jesus Christ passionately loves every person on this earth. And he's inviting us into this mission. So we can ask the Lord to give us courage, give us strength, because we know and believe that he's the answer. We know and believe that he is the way, the truth, and the life.